I don't get it. Why wouldn't Quagmire like me?
Because he thinks you're annoying. Like people who never shut up about their kids.
He would have been four today. I still don't understand. How do you drown in an inch of water?
Well, I guess I don't have a new sweater and a haircut.
Perhaps we should just continue the party at some other type of location.
No. Wait. I know this guy. We went to high school together.
We did?
Oh, yeah. He was a loser then, and he's a loser now. Oh, we used to kid this guy all the time. Bob misses his mommy. Bob misses his mommy.
Well, I hate to say it, but I guess we're supposed to dig this kid up. Any volunteers?
I dig kids.
Well, what is it then?
I'm pregnant!
Dad, I swear to God I didn't know that when I set you up with her.
You're pregnant, Meg, and there's only one thing to do.
Meg, can you turn over? I gotta get that thing out of there. You're sitting on my shirt. I gotta put it on this hanger.
Now, I'm going to Michael's house to force him to marry you.
Big news out of Six Flags Columbus today as they unveil what promises to be the largest roller coaster in the United States.
That's right, Joyce. They call it the Holocaust. The ride has several Jewish groups up in arms as they go over the first rise. No, I'm kidding. They're actually pretty upset.
Wow. I had heard about the Holocaust, but I never believed it till right now.
And in the city, glasses are considered really sexy.
Dang, I hope her brother don't already have dibs on her.
My daughter would absolutely love you.
Of course, tonight is Randall Evan Battencourt. God, I hate understudies.
King Louis XVI has been sentenced to death by guillotine. Yeah! The part of King Louis XVI will be played by Jean de Menard.
Relax, you're gonna do great.
Nailed it.
Let's go see the USA. They'll treat you right unless you're black or gay or Cherokee.
Oh, wow, I can't even imagine what twisted deviant act you've thought of this time.
I want you to have sex with your father.
What?
Yep, and I'm gonna watch.
Hi, Glenn.
Are you crazy? No way!
Glenn, remember, the thing we love most about each other is that we push each other way beyond our normal boundaries.
Did you enjoy your stay at the Marriott?
No, I did not.
Now, one thing that makes us more cultured than our European counterparts is high school football.
Then why are we standing here in the parking lot?
Because sometimes your team loses and you have to beat up the ref. What part of Eatonville you from, huh? What part of Eatonville you from?
Oh, West Eatonville.
Oh, really? West Eatonville? You know Bob Hanley?
I'm Bob Hanley.
No kidding. Bob, it's me, Peter Griffin.
Oh, my God. How the hell are you?
I'm doing great. Well, hey, oh, listen. I was really sorry to hear about your dad.
Oh, that means a lot.
Yeah, I'm sorry I couldn't make it to the wake. I was out of town.
It's okay. Thanks for the flowers.
Oh, it's the least I could do. Hey, Chris, get over here. You gotta meet my buddy, Bob Hanley.
Hi, Mr. Hanley. I'm Chris. I heard a lot about you, sir.
I think we're done here. No Christmas carnival.
Wow, Carter. I had no idea you were Jewish.
What? Is that how this is coming off?
Yeah, kind of. I mean, that's what everyone's saying.
People think I'm Jewish?
What's up, my sisters? Ooh, I ain't sat down in a hot minute.
What the hell? Why are you talking like that?
Sorry, I have family in town.
So, you want to go upstairs?
Sure.
Great. Go.
Wow, Stewie, you look exhausted.
Yeah, because I was up super late last night beefing your mom.
My mom's dead.
Yeah, because I beefed her to death.
Oh, what's your problem? Why are you being such a jerk?
I'm sorry, Brian. I had the absolute worst night.
Very funny. Who put the Ark of the Covenant in here?
Meg is so stupid. She couldn't handle the glory of God's love.
So how long have you been a member of the Rhode Island Society for Special Literary Excellence?
Oh, no. I'm not a member. I'm their chaperone.
Chaperone?
Yeah, uh-huh. We're in that section right over there.
Hey, there he is. It's Brian Griffin.
Damn it, Randy. You just spilled my juice box.
Oh.
They absolutely love your book. The simplistic writing style is very graspable to them.
Here's your award. I made it all by myself.
Thanks.
Hey, Brian, smell my finger.
I already can.
You know, I gotta tell you, I think you did a good thing.
Well, I guess I just realized it's not about me. This family is what's best for Anna Lee. This is her home now. I gotta let her go.
I'm proud of you, Quagmire.
Thanks, man. Hey, who knows? Maybe I'll bump into her in 18 years.
What?
Did you really think I was gonna change that much? Get out, everybody!
It's heading for the first dead baby joke ever written!
Well, at least I didn't get robbed. And what can I do for you four fine black gentlemen today?
So I'm going to prove to you that there is no such thing as someone who is psychic, and that with the most minimal training and the right set of buzzwords, anyone can appear to be psychic. Even a complete boob like Peter. Watch this.
Excuse me, ma'am. I'm psychic, and I'm getting a strong feeling from you. Do you have a watch or clock that no longer works?
Wow. I used to have a watch that broke.
You see, just by asking very general questions that would apply to most people, a person can appear to have inside knowledge about you.
I'm also sensing that you have a dead relative.
My husband died of cancer last year.
Oh my God, awesome. Okay, I'm sensing some other bad stuff.
My daughter was just in an accident.
Sweet, high five.
You're awful.
Hey, you don't want to hear the truth? Don't come to the park.
Okay, you made your point.
My God, what is this?
This must be the McBurger Town Slaughterhouse.
Sir, you are correct. But in here we call it Dachau.
Dachau?
Dachau. Except we spell the cow part C-O-W, like cow. So it's kind of a dark joke.
Yeah, it's a Holocaust joke. That's really funny.
God, this is a more disturbing sight than Tom Hanks and E.T. in Philadelphia.
Ouch.
There you go, you're good.
You didn't touch me.
I don't want to get AIDS.
But before we begin, I'm just going to use the park bathroom at night.
Stewie, no!
I got a lollipop!
That's great, bud. Now let's stop talking about that lollipop and get to work.
We now return to Meredith Baxter in Raped by a Clown.
It was awful. He made me do things. Awful things.
What kinds of things?
I don't even want to talk about it.
Hey everybody, welcome back to The Price is Right. Time to spin the wheel. Top winner for the day is Peter, so you're going to be the first to spin it. Go ahead, Peter. Close as you can to a dollar without going over. All right, while we're waiting for the wheel to spin, you want to say hi to anybody?
Oh, yeah, Drew, I want to say hi to Lois, Brian, Chris, Dewey, Meg, Joe, Bonnie, Quagmire, Cleveland, Mort, Seamus, Adam West, Dr. Hartman, Bruce Carter, Babs, Tom Tucker, Angela, Opie, Carl, Herbert, Jillian, Consuela, Giant Chicken, Grease Top Deaf Guy!
Okay, sure they're happy to hear that.
Whoa, paramedics, come on down!
Are you okay?
All right, class, two things today. I'm no good at math, and I don't have a certificate to teach driver's ed, so I hired a math tutor and a driver's ed guy. Okay, so do you use my car, or do you have, like, a special one you brought?
I'm the math tutor.
Really? No way! So that means you're the...
driver's ed instructor, yes.
Well, I'll be a son of a gun. All right, time to learn math from a black guy, I guess. Too bad we can't just torch the pharmacy.
Oh, come on, no, we can't do that. That'd be like stealing from the insurance companies. It wouldn't be right.
Oh, they're bastards. Last year, after I lost my beloved Muriel, our life insurance company refused to pay on her policy. They took what should have been a pleasant experience and made it into an ordeal.
Well, that doesn't totally surprise me. A friend of mine staying in my house got, injured... and my homeowner's insurance wouldn't pay her doctor bills. Said the policy didn't cover an active rod.
Yeah, come to think of it, they wouldn't even pay for the fetus Lois lost when we went to visit the Museum of Staircases and Spring-Loaded Boxing Gloves.
Yeah, you know, they don't seem to pay out on anything.
Peter, why do you look so nervous?
Yeah, I promised a kid in the hospital I'd hit a home run for him. Sorry, I struck out looking. Wait, you're not the kid I promised.
No, he died last night.
Oh, phew.
God, a time machine. This is really amazing.
Yeah, I used to tell people I had it, but, you know, it ends up becoming a hassle. It's like having a pickup truck. You know, everyone finds out you have one and they all want to borrow it. Hey, Stewie, can I borrow your time machine? I want to see the Brooklyn Dodgers. Or, I should have married the other girl. Or, I meant to introduce Jim Belushi to drugs.
All right, that's it, Peter. We've got to do something about that awful breath. I'm making an appointment and you are going to the dentist.
All right, fine. But I hate going to the dentist. Even more than I hate going to that racist eye doctor.
Okay, Peter, can you tell me what's on this bottom line?
N. I. Is that an O?
No.
Yeah, let's wrap this up. I got the director's cut of Raiders of the Lost Ark waiting for me at home.
Don't look, Marion!
Okay! By the way, I'm pregnant!
Maybe just one quick peek.
Okay, Meg, I stood outside Planned Parenthood for 36 hours, and here are the pictures of every girl in your class who went in.
All right, good. Now I want you to call them as if you're their dead baby.
No way! That was the last thing on your list. I can't do this anymore.
Well, you should have thought of that before you stole money out of Mom's purse. I own you. Now, here's my post office key. I need you to go downtown and get the stuff for my P.O. box.
You don't get your mail here?
No. I get a lot of private correspondence from the Netherlands.
Like what?
Like, I'm part of a group that kind of trashes Anne Frank's house every year.
Hi, my name's Classy. What can I do for you, hot stuff?
Oh, hi, Classy. Listen, do you have a wallet or a purse?
I have a purse.
Oh, baby. I want you to take the money out and count it really slowly.
Okay. One.
Ooh, that's nice.
Two.
Oh, my.
I'm sorry, the next bill I have in here is a 10.
Oh, I love you. All that and everything.
Hey, Charmise, you know, I really love your clothes.
I found a lot of them on strung-out teenage corpses.
That's so lovely, but I was thinking maybe this afternoon you'd like to borrow my credit card and buy yourself a new wardrobe. You know, something a little more conservative.
Really? That's so sweet, Glenn. No one's ever cared about me like that before. Thank you. I would like to pawn all these clothes for crack money.
Bye, Patty. Bye, Esther. Bye, overzealous Asian kids lining up to be the first ones in school tomorrow.
Go away. No time to say bye. I pass you because you lose focus.
Damn, lost focus. Life over.
We now return to ST, the Special Terrestrial.
All right, Rupert, I left the fat man's entire porn collection on the curb for Goodwill to pick up.
No!
Peter, where the hell are you? You gotta get down to the clam, man. There's like 60 clowns in here.
I can't. I gotta watch Stewie.
Peter, they threw what I thought was a bucket of water on me, but it turns out it was just a bunch of confetti.
Oh, man, I gotta get over there. Okay, it's okay, as long as I can still see him. Okay, Stewie, there you are, safe and sound. Daddy can still see you. Okay, Daddy can still see you. Daddy can still see you. That was a wink, but you don't know it, because it's just a eye.
Listen, I was at the hospital earlier, and I heard something I wish I hadn't.
Oh, please do not tell me it was a sexist remark, because that is not okay. You know, those nurses are busting their asses weighing people and seeing how tall they are.
Stewie, I heard a doctor tell Carter he has 2 weeks to live.
What? Are you sure?
I saw it with my own eyes.
I gotta check this out. Oh my God, you're right, he looks awful. Wait, how are we seeing this? Oh, I've got a nanny cam hidden inside his house. Watching him nail his cleaning woman is how I'm learning Spanish. Although I'm not sure what the Spanish word no means, because it doesn't seem to mean the same thing as it does here.
And the worst part is, I don't think Lois even knows he's sick.
Oh, this is going to destroy her! Oh, just thinking about it makes me all giddy.
Oh, hi, Brian.
Hey, Lois. Listen, I have something I need to tell you, but it might be difficult for you to hear.
What is it?
Lois, I think your father is dying.
What?
Ha! You really think so?
Sure I do. And look, if you really want to learn how to bang that thing, there's no better teacher than your old dad. After all, I'm the guy who taught old Asian people how to get on the subway. Out of the way! Nobody else matters! All right, you made it. Now twirl that long hair sticking out of your face mole. And cough. Cough like you never coughed before.
Bing bong, thank you for invite.
Oh, of course. Please come in.
Hey, Brian, I bet he thinks you're what's for dinner.
Come on, that's a racist stereotype.
So, when do we eat dog? Ah, just kidding. As you are aware, Asians are known for their great sense of humor, and enormous genitalia, and respect for non-Asians, and for being polite. Now, give me big American food, you fat, ugly, Kojak, bang, bang, American fat sauce.
I feel like I'm being watched.
Of course you are, silly. The Lord is always watching us.
May the sword be with you. And also with you.
Jeez, this movie sucks.
I know, it's terrible.
Excuse me, who had the stroganoff with the roasted potatoes?
Right here.
Thank you for seeing me, Your Excellency.
Of course. What did you say your name was, my child?
Lucy.
You've been lucified!
Oh, hey, Chris. This is Tyler. Don't make this weird now. Oh, what a gentleman.
Dan Quagmire!
Wally! Good to see you. This is my son, Glenn.
Nice to meet you, Glenn. You should be very proud of your dad.
I am, sir.
It was an honor to serve with him. Come on, Dan, let's get a drink. It's great to see you back in your element tonight, surrounded by seamen.
Seamen. See, Quagmire, I told you he's gay.
Shut up, Peter.
Hey, you Dan's boy?
That's right.
Your dad was very brave back in Southeast Asia. He flew supplies in where others wouldn't dare to go. I can't tell you how many loads your dad took when I served with him.
Huh?
Glenn, I wouldn't miss this night for the world. Everyone here admires your dad. He'd walk into an army barracks and make every private there feel important. Yeah, he just knew how to stroke those privates.
Oh, God.
Your dad was cock of the walk, Glenn.
Every day at rifle training, he'd help me clean my butt.
Your dad once drank me under the table.
If there was one man you wanted in your hole, it was your dad.
Your dad had the best penis in the military.
Okay, just stop! Stop! Everybody stop! Dad? Are you gay?
What?
Are you gay, Dad?
Oh, Glenn, I'm not gay.
Just tell me the truth.
I am telling you the truth. Now calm down, you're ruining this ball. You know how much I love balls.
All right, come on now, that's not helping.
Son, you have my word. I am not gay.
You promise?
I promise.
All right, I believe you.
But I am a woman trapped in a man's body. And while I'm in Quahog, I plan to have a sex change operation.
Oh, come on, just be gay.
Hey, I've gotten people to believe crazier things. And if you are pure of heart and deed, you'll all go to a beautiful place called heaven. I'm yanking you. You're just rotting the ground.
Ground zero. So this is where the first guy got AIDS.
Peter, this is the site of the 9/11 terrorist attacks.
Oh, so Saddam Hussein did this?
No.
The Iraqi army?
No.
Some guys from Iraq?
No.
That one lady who visited Iraq that one time?
No, Peter, Iraq had nothing to do with this. It was a bunch of Saudi Arabians, Lebanese, and Egyptians financed by a Saudi Arabian guy living in Afghanistan and sheltered by Pakistanis.
So you're saying we need to invade Iran?
Welcome to Fox News, Lois. We're very excited to have you.
Well, I'm excited to be here. Oh, this is my dog, Brian. He was just dying to see the studio.
Well, hi there, Brian.
How's it going, Adolf?
I'll have you know my grandparents died in the Holocaust. No, I'm just joking. They were there, though.
This is going to be way better than when we had that Victorian girl ghost over for dinner.
My governess drowned me in a well.
You are a horrible dinner guest.
And then there was Quag Chambers. He was the leader of our gang. He had sex when he was 5 and committed his first rape when he was 10. Rape, of course, being legal in the 50s.
I've been thinking about that. See, you're a dog, and I'm a man, right? So we're basically Scooby-Doo.
So what are you saying?
We go around town and rip off faces until we find a real killer. Unless... Which can only mean... Twins? Guess again. The newspaper is embarrassing me. Well, and I'll just find a doctor out of town. Listen, I know I'm not a regular patient, but I think I have some trouble with my prostate. So, can you help me out, Dr. McCoy?
What? So you can sue me, too?
Oh, come on, it'll only take a sec.
Forget it. I'm a doctor, not a patsy.
Hello?
Quagmire and Cleveland are great with kids, like Robin Williams and Patch Adams.
Huh, everybody's lying around in here. Liar, liar, pants on fire. What am I, in Congress? Huh-huh. See? Laughter is the best medicine.
Please, sir, I'm in so much pain.
Shut up and listen to my material. Huh, what's this? Bedpan? Peter Pan. Oh, next stop is Neverland.
Come, Wendy, fly with me!
Ho-ho!
Like the episode of All in the Family, where Archie got the Jeffersons to move.
Time for you to move there, Jefferson.
Oh, Archie! I can't see out of my sheets!
Ain't it? Well, you stifle yourself. We're supposed to be incognitus.
And who could forget that classic episode of The Waltons?
Good night, Jim Bob.
Good night, Mary Ellen. Good night, Paul.
Good night, Jim Bob. Good night, Elizabeth.
Good night, Pa. Good night, Ma.
Good night, Elizabeth. Good night, John Boy. Good night, John Boy. John Boy?
Damn it! Can't a guy masturbate in this house?
We're the best pals since the Snorks!
Oh, I'm having a really great time.
Me too. I really value our friendship. You're not like those other Snorks who only want one thing. Oh, that was clumsy. Hang on a second.
You go together. Like the couple from the movie Grease.
Mr. Rama-Lama-Lama-Kadinga-Da-Dinga-Dong, do you take Miss Shubop-Shawada-Wada-Yippity-Boom-De-Boom to be your wife?
I do.
And Miss Shubop-Shawada-Wada-Yippity-Boom-De-Boom, do you take Mr. Rama-Lama-Lama-Kadinga-Da-Dinga-Dong to be your husband?
I do.
If anyone objects to this union, speak now or forever hold your peace.
Mr. Chang-Chang-Changity-Chang-Shabop!
We now return to the E! True Hollywood Story. Alf. By the third season, I was completely wasted all the time. I lost all control of my bodily functions. They had to cut the crap out of my fur before each taping. But, would I do it all again?
We need to do the right thing. Like the dad from Small Wonder.
All right, Vicky, time to shut you down for the night.
Good night. See you tomorrow.
Nah.
We need a new fourth guy for our group. We're a man short, like Statler without Waldorf.
You know, without the other guy yapping in my ear, these guys aren't half bad.
Besides, it sure beats the hell out of last Saturday when we partied with that bighorn guy from Legend.
Hey, you guys want to go to IHOP, get some breakfast or something?
Oh, God, I don't know, bighorn guy. It's like 3 a.m.
Oh, that sucks, man. I'm wide awake. Hey, Quagmire, you want...
Oh my God, I'm sorry, man, are you okay?
No!
I didn't see him.
We now return to House Hunters Westeros.
I love it. Sold!
Be warned, Khaleesi. The fourth bedroom has no point of egress, and the HOA is known to be unmerciful.
Shame! Shame!
Trash cans must be off the curb by 10 a.m.
And pick up after your dragons!
And there's a Twinkie factory in Natick.
Twinkies?
Yeah, I saw a story about them on A&E.
And now back to A&E's biography, Twinkie the Kid.
It was difficult for Twink to play with other children. He was different. Mm. He was definitely he had no bones, and he couldn't really play any sports.
Yeah, and that's, you know, why we got him the lasso.
Yeah.
He'd spend hours in the backyard playing Wonder Woman. He's gonna kill me.
He loved that lasso. Mm. He not as much as the baton, but we put a stop to the baton. He was different enough, you know.
Oh, what a feeling! Oh, this is even better than that time I met Timer the Cheese Guy.
A hanker for a hunk of a slammer slicer junker. A hanker for a hunk of cheese. When you get up and go, has got up and went. Howdy, partner!
Yeah, pardon me, sir. I live next door. It is 3:30 in the morning. I am very tired.
Look, a wagon wheel!
What the hell is your problem?
I just smoked a whole bunch of crack!
Well, we better get there soon. I want to be there for opening night of Karate Kid 5.
Mr. Miyagi, this is kind of embarrassing, but I'm having a problem with erectile dysfunction.
Aye, Danielson. Miyagi fix.
Like when I worked in that lab with Dr. Bunch and Honeydew.
Agreed, Peter.
Well, this day has taken a bad turn, like Mike Brady's first marriage.
Here's your beer, honey.
Huh. I don't remember asking for a warm beer.
Well, I didn't want to quit working. You made me.
You don't talk to me that way!
Alice, what did you see?
Enough to know I'm getting a raise.
I am not. I'll tell you who's a fraud. Mr. Spark.
Mr. Sulu, set a course for...
One moment, Captain. They're about to announce the winning numbers for the Intergalactic Lottery.
Today's winning numbers are 18, 24, 41, and 72.
Ah, yes! You're damn right! Hell yeah! You can suck it! You can suck it! You can suck it! You can all suck it! Live long and suck it!
Met the player who would become my arch rival, Sweden's Head Benson. He'd bring his personal chef to every match, which was very distracting. Ah! What the hell?
Burgy, burgy, meatball throwy.
Come on, this can't be legal. What are you, blind?
Serve ball!
And now back to the facts of life.
Hey, Mrs. Garrett, can I ask you something?
What is it, Joe?
Is it a problem if your penis and your vagina touch each other?
What?
Well, I try to keep them separated, but I woke up this morning and they were sort of together. I just didn't know. Is that okay?
You have both?
Well, yeah. Doesn't everybody?
No!
Well, maybe you're not as good a father as me, eh? I mean, look what I did with Chris. I'm even better than that dad on Lost in Space.
We need to gather more information about this new planet. Don, you take my 16-year-old blonde daughter out in the chariot for the rest of the day. Penny, you stay here with me. And Will, you and the robot go out into the uncharted wilderness and take this mincing boy-hungry pedophile with you.
Oh, but you meet such colorful characters in taxis, like Alex Rieger and Tony, and that funny foreign guy who worked in a garage.
Rieger, cab 402! Nardo, you and your luscious melons are in 315! Now get the hell out of here, you losers!
Hey, Louie, what about the foreign guy?
No way, Banta, he's a nut job.
Come on, Louie, show a little compassion for once in your miserable life.
All right, can of waterworks, Jackie Chan, cab 302.
Thank you very much.
We now return to Top Chef, Looney Tunes edition.
Okay, Chef Fudd, I was a little disappointed in you this week. Your dish was just a live rabbit who thought he was taking a bath.
But I used carrots and celery.
Yes, I saw he was scrubbing his back with a long celery stalk. Chef Sylvester, on the other hand, I'm happy to say your suffering succotash was absolutely delicious.
Thanks.
Right, you're not thinking clearly. All right, you've got to agree to this surgery. Because right now, you're as useless as Black Widow is to the Avengers.
So, what's your superpower?
Kicking.
Oh, right, because none of us can kick. Hey, which one of you guys can kick? Hulk, stop being nice.
Sorry.
You know who was my hero? Aquaman. And his secret alter ego, Arthur Curry.
Wow, you saved our lives, Aquaman.
Just doing my job.
Arthur Curry! Did you see Aquaman? He was just here!
Oh, darn. I must have missed him.
We forgot to tell him thanks.
Oh, I have a feeling he already knows.
Fine, go ahead. It's not gonna be the same. Like Cheers wasn't the same when they brought in Kirstie Alley.
Norm!
No, I'm Rebecca.
Oh no, that movie's long gone, like the original ending to Grease.
We've been up here for 4 days. Why did you drive the car into the air if you didn't know how to get it back down?
Look, Sandy, it seemed like a good idea at the time. Obviously, I didn't think ahead.
It's so cold. Let's cuddle together for warmth.
I'm warm enough.
We now return to Sesame Street, now on HBO.
In other news, Quahog will be experiencing rolling blackouts to help meet Superstore USA's extensive power demands.
Oh, in fact, Channel 5 has just received this message from the electric company.
Hey, you guys!
Contrary to those upbeat lyrics, the electric company would like us to emphasize it will not be bringing you the power.
He's right, Peter. You've disturbed the natural order of things. People need to be able to die.
No!
I think I'm going to be okay.
Oh, Jack, now we can get married and everything you promised.
Yeah, about that. I was pretty sure I was going to die. Because there's this girl in New York, and it's getting kind of serious. But, you know, thanks for letting me draw you naked.
I still can't believe you let me do that.
Come on, Lois. It's the one thing I look forward to at work. It's the one thing I'm good at. I am to birthdays what J.K. Rowling is to now problematic wizard stories.
Perhaps Slytherin, or maybe Hufflepuff, or trans women aren't really women.
Wait, what?
I mean, the first two things. Okay, who's the next girl or boy? There's only those two.
It's like a cross-dressing Cobra Commander.
Who?
Cobra Commander. He's the head of Cobra, the bad guys from G.I. Joe. The guys who oddly shout the name of their terrorist organization as they're attacking.
Guys, we're under attack!
By who?
I don't know!
Cobra!
Oh, it's Cobra.
Oh, of course. Look, they have the pictures of the snakes on their planes.
Duke, what have I been saying for years? What makes a good terrorist organization?
Brand recognition.
Brand recognition.
That's everything.
You know, you really should talk to a therapist about this. I mean, it really helped Peter out when he became obsessed with that fantasy world of his.
Yeah!
You're a little too heavy, buddy.
Yeah!
We're going down.
Yeah! Yeah!
We're actually working for the federal government, and we need your help. Do you want to be spies like us?
Can we be spies like them?
We've actually resolved our differences.
I can't believe I missed it! Jeez, I hope I don't end up stuck in here like Winnie the Pooh.
Rabbit, perhaps you should push with your shoulder and not your fist.
Don't worry about it.
Man, look at them. They make such a cute couple. Like Pac-Man and Ms. Pac-Man.
No. He knows I'm his friend.
Yeah, right. That's what Woody thought about Buzz Lightyear.
Bo Peep! What's going on here?
You've got a friend in me?
All right, fine. But I gotta say, being Justin was quite an adventure. Like when I found where the wild things were. I owe you, Max. You led me right to them. All right, now help me grind their horns into boner pills.
We now return to VH1's Behind the Music, Dr. Teeth and the Electric Mayhem.
It must have been around 1979 when animals started snorting crushed up pieces of felt. Got pretty ugly.
Me had big problem before me found God.
He, like, threw me down and he said, I hope your puppeteer has big hands because I'm not using lube.
Me no remember that, but me believe it happened.
Jeez, I don't know what's going on with him. But I guess love does funny things to people. Look at Forrest Gump.
Hi, Forrest. I know you just got back from Vietnam and you love me, but I'm gonna go run a train with this group of Black Panthers I just met.
Okay, Jenny.
Hi, Forrest. I know you came all this way to New York to visit me, but I'm gonna go do blow and have sex with a bunch of stockbrokers.
Okay, Jenny.
Hi, Forrest. Now that I have the most contagious and incurable disease known to mankind, I'll finally have pity sex with you.
Okay, Jenny. And I'll mow the grass and raise the AIDS, baby.
Peter, the map is a joke. You're being played for a fool, like George McFly.
Hey, Lorraine, whatever happened to that guy Marty from high school?
Don't know. Never saw him after the prom.
Really? Sure you didn't run into him, Mo, say, about 16 years ago?
George, what are you talking about?
I'm talking about the fact that our son, who you insisted we name after that guy Marty, looks exactly like him. You think I'm an idiot? That I wouldn't notice that our son is a dead ringer for the guy who fixed us up?
Mom, Dad, I accidentally set fire to the living room rug.
I am not going easy on him.
And now back to the life and times of Grizzly Adams.
Grizzly? Who's Steve?
What?
Oh, there's a message on the machine from somebody named Steve.
Oh, yeah, Steve. He's new to the mountain. I met him down at the general store. He makes canoes.
Oh. How come I've never met him?
He hasn't really been here that long.
Long enough to get your number!
Ben! Ben! Damn it.
I was the human resources director for the Muppets. Mr. Beaker, it is my unfortunate task to inform you that your services will no longer be required by this company. Well, if you must know, it's because we've noticed large quantities of benzene, ephedrine, and everyday Epsom salt have gone missing. Oh, please, we both know those are the ingredients used to make crystal meth. And I've got a pretty good idea who you've been selling it to as well.
Oh, hey, Beaker, when you're done talking to your friend, I want to talk to you about that thing.
We now return to the Smurfs.
Hey, you have a good time last night?
Smurf-tacular.
Yeah, I saw you leave with Smurfette.
Oh, man, as soon as we got out of the bar, she started smurfing me.
Shut the Smurf up.
Yeah.
Right in the Smurfin' parking lot?
Smurf, yeah.
Oh, that is freaking Smurf.
You Smurf it.
That is freaking Smurf.
Yeah.
Not all kids make it, Lois. Just ask the Sugar Smacks frog.
I'm sorry. I'm afraid you've lost two more. What should we do about the graves?
Dig 'em.
Oh, things are gonna be different. No more will I treat you like some kind of alien.
3 minutes to minimum safe distance.
Stop. Not so fast, y'all. You think you can just up and run away? You crazy. I like to eat people from other planets, especially y'all.
I like to eat you with my little mouth, too.
Oh, now y'all get back up inside me, little mouth.
I wants to play, too.
Get back inside. I'll get you when we's eating them.
This guy may look harmless on the outside, but on the inside, he could be a complete bastard, like Fred Flintstone.
So, why exactly do you want this separation?
Well, Mr. Stoneberg, in a nutshell, the cat put me outside. I was banging on the door for like 20 minutes shouting, Wilma!
I didn't hear you.
Oh, there's no way you didn't hear me.
I was in the shower.
Oh, she was in the shower.
The elephant's you trunk was on right full blast. On I couldn't door, hear you. And besides, you're always yelling about something.
All you do is spend my money on expensive clothes
and hairdos. How am I supposed to know when to pay attention?
But when I want to get my rugs off, you know where to be found, you passive aggressive bitch.
Babs, you want to sit and watch?
No.
I'll have you know that I can bench press over 690 billion nanograms.
Sheldon, that's less than 2 pounds.
It sounded better the way I said it.
Oh, when I tell that joke at work tomorrow, people are going to be sorry they didn't come.
And I was quite a troublemaker myself when I was a kid.
Look, your parents will be home any minute. Are you sure you don't want me to clean up this mess?
No. Go. It'll be funny.
Wow, that's some nose you got. Yeah, one time it almost got me a spokesman deal.
Follow your nose. Follow your nose. Follow your nose.
Oh, I'm sorry. No, that was good. I didn't think you were going to go so cartoony with it.
Well, how would you read it?
Oh, I don't know. I was thinking of doing it, you know, good, like an actor. But, you know, your way is good, too.
I hope so, because if I blow this, I'm going to have to go back to my old job at the electric company.
Duh.
At. Dot.
Buh.
Et.
Bet.
Bet. I knew that. Slow it down.
Puh.
It.
Pit.
Hit. Come on, pal. It's my first day.
Buh.
At.
fat.
Oh, that's it, buddy.
So I see here you worked for a family for a number of years. Can I call the, Herculoids for a reference? I'm sorry, I don't understand. The position has been filled. The position has been filled. Thank you very much. You can go now. Leave now! I didn't think it was going to be this hard to choose a babysitter.
It's the worst job I've had since I was the conductor for the Sand People Choir. And a one, and a two. No. The altos were early. Now, this is the worst glee club I've ever... Oh, come on. Where are you going? The benefit's tomorrow.
Relax. The Sand People frighten easily, but they'll be back. And in greater numbers.
Well, that'll give us a richer harmony.
Oh, yeah, no, it's going to sound fantastic.
Like the way Commissioner Gordon tells Batman that he just took a poop.
Ugh, I don't need to know about that.
This story breaks, it's gonna be big. Like when Horton heard The Who.
That's not singing, it's just screaming.
We now return to Magnum BM.
Magnum, I found a fingerprint smudge at the crime scene. Do you have poo on your hands?
A little.
Genetic modification is a real thing. It's going to change the world, just like James Taylor changed rock and roll.
Hello, Martha's Vineyard. Are you ready to watch me play guitar on a stool?
Yes, thank you.
No, thank you. Now here's a song that's basically directions to Boston.
Oh man, this is the happiest day of my life. Now I know how Barbara Streisand must have felt the day she married James Brolin.
I love you.
I love you too. Ah, I'm so glad I married a regular person and not a celebrity.
I'm really cutting loose, just like Julie Andrews in that movie where she showed her breasts.
Oh, Mary, you'll never leave us, will you? Yes, those are lovely, but it doesn't quite answer our question.
Okay, Johnny Depp or Richard Grieco?
Oh, that's gross.
Well, let's not do this.
Come on. If you're secure in your masculinity, you can answer a simple hypothetical.
All right, Johnny Depp, because he kind of looks like a chick, I guess.
What about you, Peter?
Oh, man. I don't know. Richard Grieco would probably appreciate you more. You know, not take you for granted. I mean, with Johnny Depp, it's like he wouldn't really need you. You know, he'd probably sneak out after you fell asleep. Of course, with Johnny, you get the financial security. I'd go with Johnny.
And now back to Old People Agree with Arnold Palmer.
Tomato soup, grilled cheese, and a weak cup of tea is the best lunch in my book.
He's right.
I enjoy things I remember.
Plenty of people cheat. Once again, Ashley Simpson.
That's how I won friends when I worked for E.
Seabiscuit! Seabiscuit! Would you mind talking to E?
I'm not Seabiscuit. I'm Penelope Cruz.
And you're just lovely. Would you like a carrot? Good girl.
This is the best idea I've had since I slayed that dragon. Sybil Shepherd?
Yes.
People, you are free!
Ugh, if he dies, I'm gonna have to start hanging out with The Rock again.
One's a baby, and the other's black, I think. At least part black. Or Hispanic. I think, you know, possibly there's some Filipino in there. Yeah, possibly some Filipino. I mean, if he's black, it's definitely diluted. I mean, one of his parents must be white. What the hell is Jessica Alba, for that matter? If I were 40 years younger, I would plow that till next July.
Now I know how Alec Baldwin feels when he feeds his brothers.
There you go. There you go. Eat up, Stephen. You're the weakest.
Hey, bud, take a break. I'll take over. Go smoke a fatty.
Thanks!
This is Sierra Tango 817, Matthew McConaughey's private jet, requesting permission to land.
Matthew McConaughey? Oh, sorry, Sierra Tango 817, all our runways are filled.
But it looks empty from up here. We're almost out of fuel.
No, no, no room at all. But lucky for you, there's a big new airport out in the middle of the ocean. Keep going, you can't miss it.
Roger that.
Oops. Well, look at it this way. I just got you on next year's Oscar telecast. You'll be right after Ron Howard! Just messing with you, Ron. Or maybe not! No, seriously, I am. Or am I? No.
We now return to Tony Danza and Sylvester Stallone in... What?
Hey!
Hey!
Hey, hello! Hey, hello!
Hello, my name is Ron?
Hello!
Hello, my name is Ron. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that.
What? You can be successful writers like Ben Affleck and Matt Damon.
Huh, there, finished. Good Will Hunting by Matt Damon.
Hey, you think we could put both our names on that?
What? You've done nothing but eat briars and smoke pot for the last 6 months.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Come on, I helped.
Oh, yeah? Okay, write a line. Just right now. Just pitch me a line right now.
Okay. How about that?
That wasn't a line. You just farted.
Is there any more pot?
Are you kidding, Brian? These men and their redneck lifestyle really speak to me. This is the greatest show I've seen in years. Not like the last time I was at a comedy club. I hear this guy's hilarious. He played Kramer, you know.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
I've been a worse wife than Lorena Bobbitt when she was married to the Thing.
Oh my God, where is it? Where'd she throw it? Oh God, oh God!
Is this what you're looking for?
Hey, hey, some of our greatest actors started in news. Like Sean Penn.
Today's weather calls for, breezy skies and sun, and there's gonna be a... Get that camera out of my face!
Sometimes people just need a little encouragement to succeed, like Jason Biggs got from his grandfather.
Jason, I want you to promise me one thing. Always be forgettable.
I will, Grandpa.
Hey, that's just a regular unattractive guy who's not famous.
We did it, Grandpa.
You don't want to mess this up, like Skeelo messed up his wishes.
I wish I was a little bit taller, I wish I was a baller, I wish I had a rabbit in a hat with a bat.
Skeelo?
What?
You need money!
Alright, fine. Guess I'm not the first person to cave into family pressure, like Stephen Baldwin.
Why aren't you a bloated alcoholic yet?
I'm sorry, Ma!
Can I talk to someone else? Literally anyone?
I'm Gilbert Gottfried, and I was fired by Affleck for no reason.
Well, there was some reason.
I'm staying, and I'm running the company with Big Bird, since he's at HBO now.
I'm actually Gwendolyn Christie. I played Brienne on Game of Thrones. I fear I may be a bit late.
You get the company!
You ain't ever getting that invite to dinner with the Gyllenhaals. Muddy was right. He never got invited to dinner with Jake Gyllenhaal or his sleepy-eyed sister. Which is probably for the best. She looks like she chews with her mouth open.
Looks like someone learned how to fight.
Yeah, I got a whole Karate Kid thing.
What's that? I'm only allowed to watch Kirk Cameron movies.
Ah, you poor dude.
Out.
Are you serious? You cannot be serious!
I had a hard time telling if people were serious.
I spilled spot remover on my dog, and now he's gone.
Are you serious? Look, they even have the payphone Denise Huxtable would call from on a different world. Hi, Dad. College is great.
I'm doing what I want to actresses and will get support from my wife, Camille.
That stuff was more out in the open than I remember.
He's angrier than Al Pacino's forehead liver spots.
Comb your hair down instead of up. Give us some shade. We're dying up here.
Yeah, what do you call that haircut? You're nearly 80 years old. You look like the kid from Jerry Maguire.
What are you going for with all of these spots?
I want to look like mashed potatoes with the skins on.
When the Dwayne Johnson Center for Confusion Ethnicity approached me about hosting this night, I said it'd be an honor to bestow upon Stuart Gilligan Griffin our Lifetime Achievement Award.
I'll tell you what I was thinking. I was thinking we lived in a safe neighborhood, but apparently I was wrong.
Wait, you're saying you were wrong?
Oh, I get it. The Fonz can't say wrong.
No, Peter, he's 70. He's having a stroke.
And let's be honest, if I had stayed with the Griffins, I would have ended up like Rick Springfield today.
I wish that I had Jesse's job.
We now return to Bryan Cranston Sneezes.
Achoo! Thank you.
I even managed earth, wind, fire, and pollen for a little while, but I had to give it up.
Do you remember? Achoo! When it was high, September.
Achoo! Oh, September is the worst month for pollen.
All the most important Broadway people will be there. Playwrights, money men, even Stanley Kowalski.
Hi, I'm Michael.
Michael! Michael!
And this is my wife, Nancy.
Nancy! Nancy!
And this is our Uzbekistani friend, Boyakov Roychescu. Hi.
I brought a gift. Put it to your ear. You can hear the ocean.
It's broken or something. All I hear is...
It's Billy Ocean. Oh, God! I got loads more.
I think you and I are going to have a lot of fun together. Well, that doesn't sound good. All right, I'm going to go out and look for him. I'll take my Don Don.
Well, I can't go outside. It's cold out there.
Tom, I'm standing here with Stephen Hawking, the first white man I've ever met who knows math better than me. Mr. Hawking, what does the discovery of this black hole mean to you and your research?
I am overjoyed. This is the crowning achievement of my career. It validates the work of a lifetime.
It certainly does. Back to you, Tom.
All right, we're clear.
I'm telling you, man, this shtick is getting so old. That chair smells, dude.
Hey, Steve, surf's up!
All right, see ya, bitch.
Oh, well, I guess sometimes you're just right for the part. Like James Earl Jones playing Darth Vader.
So, James, we just want you to do the voice.
From Time Life Music comes a one-of-a-kind Rat Pack collection, their most bigoted songs. All your favorite once-acceptable hits like Drunk Old Engine.
The drunk old engine squatting in his teepee. Fire water keeping him warm.
Jewish Nose.
She's got a big, beautiful Jewish nose, and it's there 2 minutes early wherever she goes.
Dean Martin singing Chinaman's Chants.
And Mr. Chinaman saying his Chinaman way. A ding a ling a ching a chong a ching a chong too.
Pew Stinky Frenchman.
Paris is lovely and Nice sure is nice. And Marseille is charming with champagne on ice. But you stinky Frenchmen haven't a clue. Pew stinky Frenchmen, frog you.
Hey there, Fruity.
Hey there, Fruity, you can do my hair.
Hey there, Fruity, don't touch me down there.
Hey there, Fruity, again I don't approve.
And many more.
Yeah, like that old gypsy did to Britney Spears in that Stephen King book.
Thicker.
Where the devil is everyone? This place is more deserted than James Gandolfini's workout room.
Great. This was a bigger waste of time than Ringo's songwriting.
Hey guys, I wrote a song.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, good, Ringo.
Fantastic.
You know what? I'm gonna put it right here. Right on the refrigerator. That way we'll get to see it every day.
All right. Ugh, will you please hurry up? It's 100 degrees out here. Ugh, you're a worse parent than Britney Spears.
I know. Oh, the gift basket was not worth the trip. Not by a long shot. Oh, I gotta get that. I'll talk to you later.
Oh, I say, this is an even bigger accomplishment than getting Minnie Driver's head to fit on screen. Okay, back up. Further. Move back some more.
What?
Back up some more.
I'm as far away as I can get.
Okay, have her enter. Action. Damn it. Cut.
Oh my god, what's happening to me? I'm like that Texas woman who gave her son brain damage by holding him underwater. I'm just like Barbara Bush.
I haven't seen this much denial since John Travolta married Kelly Preston.
John, do you take Kelly to be your wife?
I totally do. I mean, yeah, yes, absolutely. And I'm gonna do stuff to her too, like touch her? Yeah, touch her and kiss her and touch her penis. I mean, no, not that.
Trust me, it makes it that much more special when we finally get inside and see Renee Zellweger doing her whole scrunch face routine.
Coming this March, Jude Law and Renee Zellweger in The Picnic.
Oh,
Oh no, these ants are ruining our picnic.
You mean this picnic is ruining our ants?
So don't try to deny it, pretty baby. You've been down so long you can hardly see.
Hey, Stewie, 3 o'clock, time for the view.
No, 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 not again! Yeah, let me out of here! I can't watch another second! Yeah, this is worse than being Kevin Federline's magic mirror.
Magic mirror, how can I look like a douchebag today?
Well, Kevin, I would say, first of all, don't shave or shower.
Okay, I won't.
And, you just got out of bed, right?
Yeah.
I would say just go ahead and wear that tank top all day.
Okay.
All right, so we cover the hygiene, no collared shirts, oh, and don't forget to walk around with an undeserved sense of accomplishment.
Dinner's almost ready, kids.
Wow, Lois, look at you. You're like Britney Spears. Except you're not a fat guy.
Oh, that's easy. I wish I could see what Kelly Ripa was like off the set.
So it shall be.
Great show today, Kelly.
Thanks, Reed. You too.
Hey, Kelly. Gelman needs us on stage for a couple of reshoots.
Be right there, Reed. I just have to put on my face.
Oh, yes, with this close to sign.
Oh, Keanu Reeves, wow. You know, I don't usually gush, so you'll have to forgive me, but when I was writing Coast Guard, that's what I do, I'm a writer. Anyway, when I was writing Coast Guard, I couldn't think of anyone other than, there's a woodpecker on your head.
Yeah, he comes and goes.
Ooh, how deliciously evil looking. It's like something out of Stephen King.
Okay, for my 307th book, this couple is attacked by a lamp monster.
Ooh, ooh.
You're not even trying anymore, are you? When can I have it?
Oh man, I better save my autographed picture of Dean Cain. You know, from before he got all desperate for attention.
Hey, is that Dean Cain on that park bench?
Oh God.
You know you're a redneck when your gun rack has a gun rack on it.
You suck!
Boy, am I beat.
Peter, what's with the tie?
Oh, I bought a tie so I can loosen it when I'm beat.
Oh my God, Dad!
Peter, your breath, it's horrible.
Is Whoopi Goldberg working out down there? Brian, either you cooperate or I blow my Adam Levine dog whistle.
Hey, my voice isn't that high.
It is. It is, though.
Okay.
Whip it good.
I'm doing my very best.
Thanks. That was way too much heat on my neck.
And now, international news from Al Jazeera. Jazeera.
Car bombing in Syria. Skiddly boom bop a dee. Yeah. 37 people killed. Ooh, the people are dead.
Face it, you're a worse parent than Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie.
I'm concerned about Pax, Maddox, and Shiloh. They're having trouble adapting. They've been raised with 11 languages and really don't speak any.
I hear you, Doctor. So, you're saying we should give them all faux hawks?
No, I think they need intensive therapy.
Let me see if I understand you. Even shorter on the sides?
I'm just going to take a little bit of his DNA, and soon we'll be proud parents, like Ron Livingston's parents.
You know, our son's a famous actor.
Really? What's his name?
He was like the main guy in Office Space.
Yeah, what else? He has dark hair. I don't know, was he in Black Hawk Down? He was in, like, at least 5 Sex in the Cities.
Ugh, what is his name? What is his name? Is your son Ron Livingston?
Yes!
Oh, God, thank God!
Ron Livingston, thank you. That has been bugging me all day.
Yeah, if we don't find that tape, we're screwed. Like anybody who goes scuba diving with Dave Navarro.
Oh.
amazing what you find when you clean your basement.
Peter, you almost done down there?
Look what I found.
That's wonderful, Peter.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go do some skywriting.
Wow, she seems great. We're getting along better than Whitney Houston and Bobby Brown.
You want to smoke some crack?
I love you.
Get the crack!
I guess you're right. Look how Chris Brown turned on Drake.
Bitch, stop pushing up on my hoes before I kick your punk ass.
Oh, pardon. I didn't mean any offense, hip-hop colleague. Can an African-Canadian just rap about neat things and drink Sprite?
I've screwed up worse than Disney did when they cast Michael J. Fox in that Zorro remake.
Who was that masked man who saved us?
I don't know, but he left his insignia.
Wait a minute, you mean we can't have sex?
No.
But, Peter, we're married.
Tony Randall was married, Lois. Rock Hudson was married. Ronald Reagan was married.
Mr. President, did you reach a missile pact?
Well, you could say that. There was a missile. And something definitely got packed.
Hey, look, why don't you go bother Joe, huh?
I can't. He's in Vegas for the weekend, seeing that handicapped Cher impersonator.
If I could turn back time, if I could find a way.
Yeah! We all want to turn back time! This is the biggest sitting ovation I've ever seen!
You'll forgive him, just like Kathleen Turner forgave her mirror.
Sorry. Turns out you were right about me.
Whoosh!
I hate him! His mouth is always open like P. Diddy.
Well, what do you mean?
You ever notice how in every photo of P. Diddy his mouth is hanging open?
Well, actually, Diddy hired a guy to close his mouth for him.
I'm telling you, this kid is the next Justin Bieber. Young girls love him, but he makes real music that...
Sorry I'm late. Traffic.
Look, there's only one way to settle this. Only the artist knows the true meaning of their art.
Now, Miss O'Keefe, the flowers in your paintings, what do they represent?
Oh, wow, that's a really good question.
Indeed, a force to be reckoned with, like Secretary of Energy Stephen Chu. Secretary Chu, Ways and Means has sent over a preliminary budget. It looks like the Department of Energy is looking at a 4% budget cut. Okay, no budget cut.
No budget cut.
I like him.
Really? Seems kind of lame. But I guess every girl has her own version of Prince Charming.
I'm in love with Paul.
I'm in love with John.
You know what? I'm in love with Ringo.
What?
I don't know what I said.
Sounded like you said you were in love with Ringo.
I don't think so.
Pretty sure you said I'm in love with Ringo. Here I am.
Are Paul and John out there?
Nope, just Ringo.
I guess you learn something new every day. Like the black-eyed peas.
Hey, what's that?
This is a guitar.
Wow.
She's always making me feel small and insignificant, like John Goodman's heartbeat.
Honey, my inside left boob stomach did that thing again.
You mean your heart?
I don't know about any of that, but I think I should eat something.
Fine, go ahead. But I'm telling you, it's going to be a bigger waste of time than writing tough guy dialogue for a Jet Li movie.
This is your last warning. Give me back my wife.
What? Excuse me?
Give me back my wife or you're in a lot of trouble. I'll kick all your faces. You got me?
You're kind of undoing everything you just did when you kicked my ass.
I know, but I have to say for audience...
Down by the old asylum.
Okay, that has to be something.
Sorry, Peter. I'm just singing along with this old John Mellencamp song.
They went up there to write a movie. Peter Quagmire, Cleveland, and Joe. Killed the old janitor, war hero. Just why, we'll never know.
I don't remember this one. Guess it's never been in a car commercial.
In a truck that spilled Dodge Tough.
Oh, yeah, no, I know this one.
Oh, God, this is already hard to watch. Like that Bourne movie where they couldn't get Matt Damon.
We're facing a biochemical attack of untold proportions. Unfortunately, Jason Bourne is not available.
Who have we got?
We have the sixth-billed guy from the Avengers. The arrow guy who frowns a lot.
Okay. Does he look like Bourne?
Yeah, yeah. He sort of looks like a young Popeye.
Well, sounds like he's the right guy for this.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mr. Griffin, you're the most generous man since Ted Turner.
I'd like to announce I'm giving a gift the whole world can appreciate. I've colorized the moon.
All right, now we're going to use a fan brush here, and I want you to take some Hunter Green, and we're going to put a happy little bush right down over here in the corner there. And that'll just be our little secret. And if you tell anyone that that bush is there, I will come to your house and I will cut you.
All right? What's more important is we're living a sweet life, huh? This is even more fun than when I performed at the White House.
Mr. President, I present to you Peter Griffin.
Booga 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 blah 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 blah.
Thank you. I'm having a good time, too. I hope I don't make any social faux pas like I did at Pamela and Tommy Lee's dinner party. Hi, sorry I'm late. I was visiting my aunt in the hospital. She has hepatitis. Ooh, sorry.
Lois, you're in an auto parts store stealing mufflers. This is worse than that Winona Ryder thing.
Are you saying I'm a klepto?
Actually, I was talking about the Age of Innocence.
It is settled, May. Our parents have consented, and you and I are to be married on the first warm, sunny day of spring.
That would be most good, Newland. Most good.
I'm sorry, but she is just awful. Is there any way, I mean, can we add like a topless scene or something?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
We can? Oh, great. All right, we got a movie.
Don't worry, Lois. Peter's good at getting out of trouble. Just like Kobe Bryant.
We want the truth, Kobe. Did you rape her?
Ooh.
What were we talking about?
That was my pleasure too, Peter.
I knew I'd get you. Just like Danny DeVito got Rhea Perlman.
I don't know, Danny.
Look, it's either me or nobody.
Sold.
That's a great idea, Peter.
Sweet. And I promise you'll be able to understand all the words. Not like Sting, where you can only understand the last three.
Stabbing up a brand.